My name is James Roth. I'm an OBGYN. I have been since 1993. Frequently, women will say, well, if I have a hysterectomy, will I have to lose my ovaries? Will I have to go on hormones? And I have to say that area has evolved tremendously in my career. When I was a young resident, women who were 40 and older almost always had their ovaries removed at the time of hysterectomy. That is just the opposite now. If women are not menopausal and there is no pathology present in the ovarian tissue, we strongly encourage women to keep their ovaries because we know that they will do better with their ovaries in than with their ovaries out. The only exceptions would be for patients who have any signs of ovarian cancer or strong family history of ovarian cancer or repetitive pelvic pain involving the ovaries. But for the average patient who is undergoing a hysterectomy for uterine problems, we are strongly encouraging the patients to not lose their ovaries at the time of hysterectomy. We do, however, encourage them to have their fallopian tubes removed, and that is because over the last 5 or 6 years, the literature has shown that a lot of ovarian cancer actually starts in the fallopian tube. And whereas there is a benefit to keeping your ovaries, there is absolutely no benefit to keeping the fallopian tube after a hysterectomy. Similarly, when we do tubal ligation, historically, we used to take a piece of the tube out. Now we strongly encourage our patients to allow us to remove the entire fallopian tube, again, so that we can decrease the risk of ovarian cancer.